Hey guys, so this flower bed here that you just watched being planted, I think it may end up being our most bright and vivid flower bed that we have in this entire garden this season. This is our before shot, before these plants put on any growth. I just got this one planted and Paul came in and got it all mulched. It looks so good. Oh, after I got done, you know, I rough up all the soil, even though it did have some compost on top, and I exposed drip lines and everything, and he comes through and just really slicks it up and makes it look so pretty. But we have Supertunia Vista Jazzberry. We'll go front to back here on this one and take a look at all these plants, but it kind of starts right underneath the Poet's Wife Rose, which they are absolutely phenomenal. We had a storm blow through here last night, so they're a little bit like, oh, but beautiful color. So those start there and they go all the way, almost all the way around. Let me walk this direction so you can just see. My goodness, especially when it's full sun out here, when the sun is shining, they really are bright and vivid. And this is where I ended with those. And I picked up with the Superbena Stormburst right here. And the reason I did that is because when you get closer to this side over here, I've got yellow blooming Rudbeckia. And it's a very warm yellow. If you put that warm, warm yellow up next to this super bright, cool, it's almost like a neon purpley pink, I think that would look bad. I think the purple and white blooms here will look a lot better with all of those over there. So those span this whole distance. Here's the Rudbeckia, and they go right to the maple tree. And this is where we're doing our hay rack project along the fence line. We also have a layer of Truffula Pink Gomphrena. So there's a little trio right here. There's just one here. There's a little grouping, a little drift right back in here. It actually kind of goes all the way to the lamppost. And then it goes kind of around the lamppost all the way over, well, not all the way to the rose, but right in here. And these get huge. They get quite large. The first time I planted these in mass, it was actually up by our front door. Where am I pointing? Am I pointing at our front door? Anyway, I planted so many of them together because they don't even usually look this big when they're in their containers. And so I just thought, well, these look kind of scrawny. I think I need like, double. And double is not what I needed. I needed to pay attention to the tag on that one because it was just, they were massive. But they're a great one for full sun and drier conditions. They thrive in that. I also had some play in the blue. So there's two there, a little grouping of three there in front of, sort of in front of the lamppost. And then there's another little grouping of three back there. That's all I had left of that one. And so I added in another vertical interest. Let me get kind of close. These are the Angel Face Steel Blue Angelonias, which get quite tall. They kind of have stalks like a delphinium. So grouping of three here, and then there's a grouping of like six over there, right in this area. I did pop a black lace elderberry in here because that is what Aaron and I decided we wanted to put here, because there's a tremendous amount of stuff. There's a huge drain cover right here that got mulched over. Typically we don't mulch over it as much. We'll probably scoot some of that away. So we cannot plant anything right here. You can also see there's electric boxes. This is where like the storm sewer is. This is where we need to get for a lot of our things. So I wanted something that would fill this area in, but also be very soft and be something that can be cut back and be fine. So I think that's gonna be the perfect thing to mask all of this back here. And then I think what we're gonna do is come in with an evergreen further into the flower bed right here. And the last plant I don't think I mentioned yet is the Diamond Frost Euphorbia. I wanted a bright white pop right in the center, so I did a drift right in here, and then I saved just three of them to pop a little bit further this way, just to brighten up the space and break up the pinks just a little bit. So this is your before shot. I'll try to remember where I'm standing so I can stand close to the same location to give you the after. These are always so much fun to watch grow. I've just been planting up annual areas as I've had time to do it. Like if I have an extra hour, you know, maybe we finished another project sooner than I thought, so I was able to utilize a little bit of time. It's been really nice. And it feels weird that we're still kind of planting annuals at the beginning of June, but it's just, we've had kind of a weird spring. It was so cool for so long that we're still kind of playing catch up a little bit, but we're almost done and I'm really happy with this bed. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this and we'll give you updates later on. Thanks for watching. Bye.